Hi friends, today we are going to discuss about the file moving. Okay, so there can be a scenario like there will be in our automation script some file will get generated, one folder, and you don't even know the file name, and you have to move that file to other folder. Okay, so we will see static and dynamic scenarios here. Static scenario means like you know the file path and you know the file path and you know the file name. Okay, so you will move that particular file to the other file. A dynamic scenario is like you know the directory but you don't know the exact file path, you don't know the exact file name, but you want to move that to the other folder. Okay, that's the second one. And the other one will be like you can select multiple files at the same time and you will move it to the some particular directory. Okay, so let's get into this. So for this, UiPath come up with one activity called move file. Move file, this is in file, okay. System file directory. So I'm just dragging it here. So in the beginning, I have created one empty sequence. Now I'm dragging that move file into the workspace. So here, if you see that options, it is asking for a few things here. One is path, that means the source file, and other one is the destination file, and it is asking if you wanted to keep it overwrite or not. Okay, so first let's look into the path is like it is a string, it will accept only the string variable. So let's imagine I have created few files here. Okay, so what I'll do is like I'll select one file and I'm selecting this old file here and I'll keep that here. Okay, and for destination, what I'll do is I'll give this as a destination. Okay, so it will come here. So it will come here. Okay, then let's invoke something like message box so that you will come to know once this is executed, you will come to know whether this got completed or not. What I'll do here is I'll just type done. So once the move file activity got completed, then will get executed. That means you will come to know that move file activity is completed. Okay, now I'm running it. Now it started, now it's shown done. Okay, so let's go here. Now you can see here you got a in destination folder you got that file, in source it is not there. Understood. Now let's imagine now it is not there in the Now it is not there in the, this file 1.txt is not there in source. Okay, it is there in destination. Okay, but even though it is not there, let's imagine it as there in that particular file, particular path. That means this path, and let's execute this and let's see whether our activity will throw an exception or not. Okay, let me run this. Now it is showing this exception because that particular file is not there, file not found, exception is coming. Okay, so what we can do from here is you have to put this particular part of the code in try catch and you can execute it. Okay, just to check whether that is there or not. Okay, that is the one thing I want you guys to implement it. Okay, so here you understood, like here you have to give the exact file path, then only it will accept. And from this understanding we can say that it will only move a single file, not multiple files. So let's say your automation script got executed and it has generated these three scripts, okay, in this folder, and you want to move them into the destination folder. Okay, but our move file activity will support only one file. Okay, so for this, what we can do is, what I'll do here is, I'll take, I'll take one concept. I'll make use of the concept called directory. Okay, so here directory dot, what I'll do is get files, and I'll give the directory name here. So I'll go here, I'll give this directory name, and here I'm creating a new variable. It will be like file. Okay, this is already existing. Okay, here this file I have created. Now here you can see the type is generic, but we know that there are multiple files in this. That means it has to be an array of strings. Okay, so we have to change this type to array. Okay, now once I change to array, now I am giving it to the string type. Now I got this one. So here this file is having the all the file names. Okay, but our move file will pick only one file at a time. So for this, what we need to do is we need to loop through each and every everything that is presented in the array list. Okay, for that, what I am doing is I am just taking this one, and this item is there. So let's see the type of the item. Item type has to be string, because our file is a string array. Once I got this, I am having everything here, right? So I'll just pull this move file here, and instead of path giving statically, what I'll do is I'll give this one item. So what is happening, each time the loop will iterate to the list of files here, and each file you are giving here, now we are displaying as message has done. Okay, now let me execute this particular part of the code. Now you can see it is done, and our source folder is empty. That means everything has to be moved into destination. You can see everything is moved in destination. That is good. And this is how we can move multiple files. Okay, so if you execute this part of the code again, what will happen? My assumption is like this code will execute successfully. Let's see. You can see it executed successfully. Why? Means this directory, there were no files, so it is empty. In empty, it won't even iterate here, so it will directly come into the message box. It will give as done. Okay, so this is how we need to move multiple files. Okay, now another scenario, I will give you the hint I want you guys to implement. It's like what it will be like. Here you have the folder, but in this multiple files were there, you want only one particular file to be move into one particular folder to other particular folder. Okay, so what you can do is you can use the same directory got get files, and you can get the file names, and you can compare that file. Okay, and if you don't know the exact file name, you just know the format, you can use the concepts like pattern matching. Then you can identify what are the files that is having the particular pattern, then you can move them, you can identify those files, and you can move all the files into this other folder. These are the concepts that we can exploit. Okay, so once you got all the files that is of array of string type, once you know once you loop through it, that is a string, each item, that means each item here, each item will be a string. That means once you got the string here, then you can play with that code like pattern matching, and you can check if you can add other things, and you can do here a try catch as well. So I'll leave it to you guys. Please let me know if you have any issues. Yeah, that's it. Thank you.